You know, the incredible truth just keeps getting more incredible and more incredible and more incredible. And clearer and clearer and clearer. For example, the quote-unquote sin that Lucifer, to use a reified term, the sin, what is that? The sin is believing that it's possible to sin. The sin, the so-called fall from grace of quote-unquote Lucifer, is the belief that it's possible to fall from grace. The sin is to believe in separation. The sin is to believe that separation is possible. That's the sin. Not a separation, not a fall. And again, the sin of rebellion against God is to believe it's possible to rebel against God. That is the way to look at it. This is called a turnaround. This is a game-changing turnaround. When you are actually able to see it that way, it's just like, oh my gosh. And you, it only comes when your mind is stable and disciplined enough to be able to handle this, because you don't go chase after anything. If you're not used to keeping it simple and easy, you're gonna start chasing after everything when you see this. You just, you know, you're gonna come unglued because you say, oh my gosh, I got the answer. And what do I do? What do I do? And all that stuff. So you have to be very dispassionate, very disciplined to see this. And you say, okay, I see it. You know, that's what I did today. I said, oh yeah, I see that. I'm gonna go to the driving range, hit some golf balls, and just go to market, do some shopping, come back, and just, you know, business as usual. No big deal. But still, when you hear it, just like, whoa. That's, you realize it's true. And you say, I just have realized, you know, what the deal is actually. There's never been any rebellion in heaven. There's never been rebellion. There's never been any fall from grace. There's never been any separation. Okay? None of that's ever happened. It's the belief that it could happen that is the problem. That's whim. But it never has happened. It never has happened. Nothing has happened. In reality, nothing has happened at all. That's the facts. That's the truth. And of course, this upsets the apple cart. We don't realize that this whole idea to defeat, you know, Lucifer, to defeat, we've got to overcome, we got to restore ourselves to grace. We have to, you know, heal the separation. We have to reject the rebellion. We have to come out of the rebellion. We have to, you know, fix the separation, get return. All of that is delusion. That is the delusion. We don't have to do anything. Nothing's ever happened. It's the belief that something can happen that is the delusion, that is the whim. Now, I advise everybody at this time, because of the continuity issue that this has given rise to, the fact that we believed it's possible to sin against God has brought this massive chain of mental worry. Concatenation means a chain of, like, mental chain, that we seem to be bound by all these chains. And so that the continuity issue between that and realizing we've never been bound at all is quite a continuity issue. So God gave a remedy, which is a blessing to bless our spirit. It's called the Holy Spirit. And this gives us a vision, a perceptual vision of holiness and sacredness of everything without exception. And that heals the continuity problem for us. In order to prepare for that, I'm suggesting you put yourself in beautiful places, places where you just feel like, you know what? Everything's just perfect. Just, I don't want to change anything. It's so nice. It's just right. It can be anywhere, you know, wherever you feel like, hey, this is like heaven, it's like paradise, it's just, I don't want to change anything. This gets you ready for seeing everything as abiding in this incredible sacred exquisiteness, this holiness, perceiving everything you look at, it just seems to be just saturated in holiness, and you don't want to change anything. There's no motive to change anything, okay? This gets you ready for it. So I'm in that phase right now. I went out today and sort of starting to set up, prepare some things for this holiday. To get into that situation is really important right now, because you cannot get into an aggressive stance going forward in this world. You have to get into a stance of, my feeling is I don't need to change anything. And just abide in that. Getting ready for the vision of holiness that the Holy Spirit has for us. And so I encourage everybody to do that. Help each other out. You know, if you can help anyone out, take them, you know, go someplace, just sit there and say, wow, this is just awesome, perfect. I don't feel like needing to change any of this. Let it be exactly the way that it is forever, you know, that kind of feeling. Very important. Don't have to spend a lot of money. You know, we went today to a place that's like that, and lunch was $20 for two people, including tip and everything, and then I hit $4 for range balls, so it cost $24, and two gallons of gas, which is about $7.50. So $30 actually for a Sunday, $30 and spending a day just feeling like everything's just like perfect, you know. You can do it on a budget. You can do it right where you are, maybe where your house, your room, your place, your apartment, whatever you are. Or you can, maybe there's a street, a place, you know, you just see, you know, this just is perfect. Just let it be exactly how it is. And realizing you're preparing, you are preparing. Because the underpinning theory is something I have done, something that I've been able to do. So all that has been straightened out, okay? All the theory is I've looked at it, I've seen it, I've straightened it out, I know it's valid. It is valid. It all fits. So now it's just preparation mode. Pray to the grace of God, however you pray, that you be helped and supported in this endeavor, that you be given maximal support for this endeavor, because it's crucial right now, because it's choice time, and you're going to go either one way or the other. Either you're going to go to all the opinions of the ego, which are really just opinions about reality, about how do we get back, you know, how do we get redeemed, how do we get saved, how do we, you know, get on God's good side, how do we get free of sin, how do we do, but even more the opinions about this is how reality can be changed, or this is how it has been changed. All those opinions are infinite opinions. The mind generates infinite opinions about reality. None of them are true. No opinions about reality are true at all. So don't even bother judging all those opinions. Just choose the Holy Spirit's one opinion about reality. And that opinion is that everything is equally sacred, meaning everything equally abides in the pure spaciousness of God. There is no rebellion. There's no fall away from that. Where can you go? Where is there a place for delusion and reality? There's no place for delusion and reality. There's no place to fall. You can't fall out of reality. You can't go somewhere other than reality. You can't separate from reality. None of that is possible. So you can't, there's no rebellion, no sin, no fall from grace, no separation. None of that has ever happened. But we thought that it could happen. And that is whim. That is whim. That's the problem. Didn't happen. Never, has never happened, never will happen. So see, be willing to see everything as perfectly sacred, without exception. And that reminds you of reality, solves the continuity problem. Very simple stuff here. The theory is accurate. Okay, I've spent my whole life on this theory. It all holds up. It all holds together. It's very clear, very true, very accurate. And then we're just getting ready to actually start experiencing this, which is the key. So the Holy Spirit's already starting to put me into places that are very, very nice and beautiful, and setting that up. Already doing that. And so this is what's happening right now. Is find yourself in places that you can just sit there and say, oh my gosh, just let this stay the same way forever. This is wonderful. That the mood, if you can handle that mood, the more you can handle that mood, the closer you're getting to the vision of Christ, the vision of sacredness, the vision of holiness, however you want to call it. You can use any terms you want to call it, but it's same, smooth, even, everywhere. That is the key. It's everywhere, same and smooth. And it seems to just be so, you know, a feeling of sublime, exquisite sacredness is there. Not something that our intellect, our opinions about reality can generate, but the Holy Spirit can generate this for us, can do it and will do it. So So here we go. We're off and running now, and it's going to be an amazing time. Don't get away from confrontations, forcefulness, you know, all that stuff. No. Go towards the one opinion of reality, that the only one that counts. This everything just as it is absolutely perfect, wonderful. Go towards that. All important at this time to do so. All important, because the aggression of the world is going to try and pick fights with everybody in this world. Okay, you will find that out now, that there's all this attempt to have conflict, to pick fights, to stir up this aggressive conflict, to try and produce some opinion that wins, and say, well, this opinion beat the other one down, so therefore it's right. You know, that's all a waste of time and just complete delusion. Okay. So there never was a rebellion in heaven, in reality, but there was the belief that a rebellion was possible. Okay? That is the only situation that happened, and that's just simply a whim. Nothing comes of the whim at all. Nothing ever came of it. Nothing ever came of any of that, that notion that we can sin, fall from grace, separate, rebel against God. Nothing ever happened. It cannot. It can't. Absolutely can't. But we believe that it can. And therein is the whim, is our issue. And it's a continuity issue. It's all. It's just a continuity issue. Reality is exactly the same as it's ever been. Nothing has ever happened. And we just come from this opinion that all this stuff has happened to finally recognize that nothing has happened. That's a big continuity issue, isn't it? See it that way. Very great. Continue on with your good habits, and you will find yourself in better and better and better and better focus and discipline, and capable of accepting this kind of, you know, amazing direct teaching. Okay? Very great. That's it.